Hello, Comanche Native here, and today I'm showing you how to use the animated GIFs in ShareFactory. Now, the animated GIF in this program is fairly easy. Now, I haven't messed with any program like this on the computer, but ShareFactory is the best so far. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to show you some of the GIFs I've been working on. And you might be wondering, what are GIFs? Well, GIFs are an animation that kind of loops over and over and over again. Some people use it for forms. Other people use it for, you know, stuff on their computer. Now, most of my GIFs that I've been making are based on the Tomorrow's Children. And the only reason why is because this game will be ending this month. And it's going to be a sad, sad end of this month. So, when I do these, I try to get into first-person view, watch an image as takes place, and then try to make it. We're going to go to the video, go to New Project. Now, remember, do not accept any of the intros. We want to click those off. We don't want to accept any intros. We want to find the raw footage of this animation right there. So, I'm going to go ahead and take a look. All right, let's see. I do have a lot of clips, so I do apologize. Okay, here we go, right here. As you can see, it's 11 minutes and 21 seconds. This is the raw footage that I filmed in the Tomorrow's Children of this emote. I'm not going to name the project because we don't need to really save this clip at all. We're going to let it load and we're going to find the footage that we want. Okay. Now, what I would like to have her do is raise her hand up and then open up her menu and then raise her hand up again. So once I'm done with the GIF, it'll look like it's just looping. Okay, so we're going to cut the clip, split the clip in half right here, and then we're going to delete this. Okay, as you can tell, this is the right clip that we want to use. Now, there's a box around this whole clip. We don't want that. What we're going to have to do is we're going to have to zoom in, because we want to make the animated GIF as big as possible, but, you know, we want to cut out the name of the town. We want to cut out the border. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the pan zoom function, and we're going to just zoom in as much as we can. We cut out the box. We cut out the town name. We're zooming in on the subject that we want to focus on. Now, once we have it to where we like how it looks, it's kind of in the center. Now, as you see her menu, when she opens up her menu, there's kind of like another object that pops up over here to the lower left. We want to try to get rid of that. So I'm going to zoom in more because I want the menu to kind of be at the bottom. So let's get closer. I'm going to get as close as we can, just a little bit more. Try to remove that little tiny small. Hang on. A little closer, right there. There we go. Okay, now let's take a look at it. Looks pretty good. She's raising her hand. She's looking around, and then she opens up her menu, and then she just repeats. Okay, now this clip is too large. We're going to have to make this clip a little smaller, because in the animated GIF, they only give you so many seconds to use. So what we're going to do is we're going to use Time Bender, and we're going to shrink this clip to the smallest. Not to the smallest, but to the second smallest. So we're going to go ahead and make it times 2. This slows it down. It's a little fast, it's okay. Don't worry about the sound. The animated GIF area will delete all the sound and everything. And you won't see how fast she's going when you're using the GIF. So once you're done with this, we're going to go ahead and render this small clip. We're going to export to gallery. And then I'm just going to back out of this because I do not want to save it. Now the clip should be already in this area here. We go animated GIF, go create from a capture gallery. We're going to click on that, and then there's our clip that we just got done saving. We're going to click on this, and then as you see, the yellow or the orange little bar right there, that is what it's going to render. This is your animated GIF. This is how it's going to look. So what I want to do is, when she's raising her hand, I want to repeat. So once she raises her hand, the anime GIF is going to just repeat from there and then move on. Okay, so as you can see, they give you a rendered project in the middle. This is how your animated GIF is going to look. She kind of jumps. You see at the end right there, she jumps just a little bit. When it comes to the close, she gives a little jump. So we want to remove that. So what we're going to do is, the clip to our right, we're going to try to match it up with the clip to the left. And if we match it up just right, it's going to look smooth. You're not going to see a little jump. So just kind of keep doing it until you see the middle clip kind of give you a nice flow. Now sometimes it's kind of tricky because you'll see someone moving in the background or maybe something popped up. I encourage anyone to just go back in and into any kind of game that they're messing with and try to get another clip to where that doesn't pop up. Okay, let's see. She kind of shimmies just a little bit. Okay, there we go. That's a little bit better. Now, I wish in this program that you could zoom in the middle clip because it's so small. Now, if you don't want your eyes to be played tricks on, you might want to cover the bar that's kind of scrolling with your hand and just watch the animated clip. And if it looks smooth to you, then that's a clear sign that you have a good animated GIF. Okay, it looks like it's pretty good. Now the thing with these animated GIFs, you can't really save the project. So you're just going to have to render it, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to render it, and then we're just going to have to exit. Now you can share this right off, but usually I like to rename my clips. But I'm going to share it later. And like I said before, you can't really save this. You can't save it at all. Oops, sorry. You're just going to have to exit. Okay, so we're going to go to the gallery and show you where it's located. And that's our new animated GIF. And it's really easy to do. You know, you might want to get with a friend and go first person view and have them do certain moves or move around for you that you want to capture. That's kind of easy. So I say have fun with it, and I look forward to seeing more being made on this game. Oh, it's going to be a sad day when Tomorrow Children ends. But hey, let's go ahead and try to make as many GIFs for this game as well as others. So have fun with it, guys. Okay, well, this is Comanche Native, and guess what? I will see you next time.